Look at this, the life of a Century Media rock star. So you have a muscle as a tour manager.
Intense moments of the music, but I feel like it definitely is more, you know, heartfelt. So
it's more like the hardcore attitude, like friendly band and fun.
Yeah, exactly. You know, jump on your friend because he's your friend, you know. Yeah. And if you fall down, pick him up, you know. Yeah. So
You mentioned philosophy, what kind of inspiration, what kind of
I for the most recent song I wrote was really inspired by Hindu meditation, and just, I've been reading a lot of Krishna literature and you know, the Ganesha on my arm here. And I brought that into a lot of the lyrics, and I also, but everything is diverse. Is a song like The First Noble Truth is based on the teachings of Bodhidharma and Chinese Buddhism, and a song like Crushing Belial was based on just like the idea of the fall of Masada, like in the original battle of Satan and God, you know, and the fall of man. And I don't know, that's just what I read about, and I try and take little pieces of that and try and incorporate them into lyrics that that are personal to me, because I don't prescribe to any one religion, any one philosophy, because I think that limits yourself, because so many of them have similar points and things that you can apply to your own life, but if you lock yourself into some dogmatic list of rules, you really limit yourself. So that's why a lot of times I get asked about my lyrics and they're confused by how can you be talking about this in one song and this in another, and I'm like, well, because that's what I thought that day. And I realized this is what I'm thinking tomorrow, and I'd rather speak strongly about what I'm feeling right then and contradict myself the next day if I've realized I was wrong than to not speak what I'm feeling. So.
And it's a hell of a lot more interesting than writing a song about fucking a corpse.
Yeah, exactly. It's been done and it's over.
But Slayer did it well.
Oh, exactly.
I'm not saying it's bad, I'm just saying that.
Yeah, exactly. And also, you know, it's just... I can't write about things that I don't think about, you know. So to try and search for a topic just to fit, like, okay, we need the fucking brutal metal lyrics.
That's when you can tell something's fake.
To the point of how evil can you be?
Yeah, exactly. So, and I'm just not an evil guy.
Why are you videotaping me? You should be videotaping other people.
Go up one. Go up one. Up one.
Hey, Duce!
Hey, what's going on, bitch? Hold on. Going to the stage. All right. Go out and go to your left. Go to your left. Go to your right. Okay.
Wait a minute.
No, go.
Hello, Cleveland!
Is the merch out in here?
That's the stage.
Yeah, we go that way. Yep, go to the right. What's going on? Where's that goddamn brick?
I'm here.
I can't see shit. Hey, what can I get? 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Where's that guy that Ben Shadows Fall? I heard he cut locked his buddies last night. Didn't let him get the gangbang. Where is he? In my band, you'd be killed for that. We'd kill you. And then we'd leave you for the goddamn buzzards. You bitch. I'll have a drink with you later. Hi, Denmark. Rock and roll. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Cockblocker.
Yeah.
Cockblocker in hell.
You didn't get a sound check, so.
No hoods.
No hoods. But I hurt my noggin.
Shadows Fall sucks, you fucking hobos! Yeah!
What do you think of Shadows Fall, move?
I can't say anything mean.
You know, that fucking Brian guy, man, that guy's got an ass as loose as a fucking elephant's.
You're using ballsy dick up at three of them.
This is how he farts.
Thank you.